Mother Teresa of Calcutta died from a heart attack on September the 5th, 1997, after a life dedicated to helping the poor and dying. Her missionaries of charity had first come to notice in a series of BBC documentaries in the 60s. It made her famous, and offers of financial help flooded in. She used it, with the Pope's blessing, to open orphanages, leper hospitals, and homes for the dying worldwide. But there were critics who said the money would have been better spent on medical treatment, not just to give the poor a dignified death. This was her answer.
For all kinds of diseases, there are medicines and cures. But for being unwanted, except there are willing hands to serve them, and there's a loving heart to love them, I don't think that disease, that terrible disease, can ever be cured.
The world lavished honors on her, among them the Order of Merit from the Queen and the Nobel Peace Prize. Mother Teresa said she accepted these awards on behalf of the poor. She was a strong ally of the Pope in wanting to return to more traditional Catholic values. She was a consistent opponent of abortion, which often brought her into conflict with secular aid organizations. Her last major appearance was on the balcony of her home in Calcutta. She died shortly after, at the age of 87. Mother Teresa's funeral in Calcutta was nothing short of a state occasion. The missionaries of charity by now had brothers in the order, as well as the 3,000 sisters all over the world. They are now guided by a constitution she wrote for them. Many were attracted by the aura of sanctity surrounding her. She seemed little affected by the worldwide acclaim that followed her work, the honors piled upon her. She was unmoved by criticism of her preference for prayer, not politics. The distinguished congregation of world leaders heard the Vatican Secretary of State, Cardinal Santano, pay homage to her.
The poor are still with us. They must be at the very heart of our personal concern, of political action, of religious commitment.
After the ceremony, Mother Teresa's body was handed back to the sisters who had lived and worked with her. Her home would soon become a shrine to her work among the world's poorest people. Her legacy will be the lasting impact her memory has on the next generation of missionaries, as well as in the world as a whole.